my only dance move right here.
This is it. Hello, everyone. We are coming at you live tonight. We are going to be speaking to you about hypnobabies and a little bit more in depth tonight about what it is. And my husband just left, but he is going to be talking tonight about what it is like to be a birth partner of a hypnobabies mom. And that is actually something I get questions about a lot because not a lot of people have that ability to share what it's like for a hypnobabies partner to go through this process. So as way of introduction, I am Camille Walker. I blog at mymommystyle.com. I have 4 children and I love hypnobabies. I have delivered in many different ways. I've done the epidural. I've done natural when I did not know I was doing natural. And I've prepared with hypnobabies twice now, and I just love it. And husband, were we doing the partner part first? Or are you just gonna listen to me?
Sure.
Okay.
I'm just happy to be on here.
Yes. My husband is a little more camera shy.
I am a budding flower on camera.
That's true. You know, we've been married almost 13 years. Can you believe that? I can't believe that. But it's been fun to watch each other progress and change. And I will say, Paul has really blossomed in a lot of ways.
I am an accountant, so that tells you what my experience is with public speaking and speaking in front of people. But Camille has coerced me into going live tonight mm-hmm. and talking about my experience with natural birth, not me personally, but as a birth yeah. partner, and with Camille's journey using Hypnobabies was the program that she used. So I'll just jump right in if you want me to.
Yeah, well, and first before we get into what Paul has to say, I do want to share with you that when you decide that this is the choice for you, it does have to come from you because you are absolutely the one going through this and you want to make sure that your heart is really in it. But as I decided that that was going to be the journey for me, I couldn't really commit to that or feel super, super comfortable in that until I knew that Paul was with me and that he could help me and support me in that journey because so much of the process of hypnobabies and having a positive experience is about your mindset and the people you surround yourself with. So Paul's going to take that into account of what the experience was like for him, because I feel like a lot of time birth partners, whether your partner is choosing to do a medicated or a non-medicated birth, you feel a little bit helpless. You want to help your significant other get through labor and be supportive and help them. And that's something that I love so much about this Hypnobabies program, is that it has tools in place for your birth partner while you are going through that experience. So I'm so thankful that Paul is going to be sharing with us, and I'll probably interrupt him because that's what I do. But please comment if you have any questions for him, because I feel like this is a time where you could, you know, tag your partner or your husband or whoever and say, hey, listen to this, and maybe this is something we should think about or talk about or ask questions. So please tune in. We'd love to hear what you have to say.
So I guess I'll back up a little bit and share. In the prior 2 weeks, Camille shared her birth stories with all 4 of our children. We have 4. Which is crazy, but our first 2 children, Camille had naturally, not by choice. She tried to have an epidural. It didn't work.
Somewhat. Yeah. It kind of worked right towards the end, which was helpful in that transition period, but it was kind of in and out, which was a shocker, really.
Yeah, and if you're interested, you can go to her YouTube channel, My Mommy Style, and see those stories. But for me, it was, I wanted to explain my viewpoint during those 2 births when, for me, it was a very stressful experience where, you know, she was on Pitocin, we were sitting, waiting for her to progress, and then all of a sudden it was time for her to have our first 2, and
all of a sudden, aka hours and hours later. Whatever.
Yeah.
It seems like that. It was a long...
The stressful part was the epidural not working and
yeah.
on our second, the anesthesiologist wasn't available, so it was just this huge
stress.
It was
New Year's Eve. Baby was posterior. I was on Pitocin. It was like kind of a nightmare situation, really. And Paul was terrified.
I was. And I and I don't do well with blood, but, you know, for me, I didn't have any training. I almost fainted on Camille's second. The nurse was, you know, instead of caring for Camille, she was looking at me saying, "Are you okay?"
I he had to white. Sit down, like, "Yeah, are you okay?" As I'm like naturally laboring with a baby face the wrong way. It's fine. He's about to pass out.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. So it was stressful and it was difficult and I had no training. I had no idea what to expect, especially on my first.
Mm-hmm. Because you don't know. You don't know what to expect. And honestly, with any labor, they can be very different.
Yeah. So after we had our second, Camille approached me and said, "I want to try this program called Hypnobabies." And my first reaction was, "What? You want me like to hypnotize you during birth? Am I going to be holding a pocket watch in front of your face and going like this?" And I was not on board. I said, "No way, that's crazy. That's some wacky sort of voodoo magic that you want to do. I'm not going to do that." And it took you, how long did it take you to finally convince me? Maybe a month?
Yeah, probably a month.
You know, I went and I looked at their website, and I'm hoping not to offend anyone, but I'm probably going to offend people during this, but I want to be honest. I went to their website and I saw these half-naked pregnant women, and it was just weird, and I did not want to have anything to do with it. One thing I really struggle with is I have a hard time with how other people view me. And I don't want to put other people out, and I don't want to have to explain that we're going to be hypnotized during Camille's childbirth. And I really have these preconceived notions about it that later I think were resolved. And Camille's very strong-willed, so basically she just told me...
This is the way it's going down.
We're going to be doing it no matter what.
What I do want to say to all the moms watching is that whatever you do, be educated, and it's your body. Know that it's your body, it's your voice, and it's okay for you to go after what you want. And I think that depending on where you are, in whichever country or state you're in, there are certain norms, and whether that's going medicated or non-medicated, you may feel pressure from your family or community or expectations of those around you. And that's what I think I would want to share more than anything, is that I feel like there are so many beautiful ways for children to come into the world, both medicated and non-medicated, and C-sections, and it's just incredible. So there's no judgment here. This is just to share with you our experience of something new that we did not know about initially. So
yeah, here in Utah, I think the culture is definitely the epidural route.
Oh yeah.
All my sisters, my mom, Camille's sister, all had epidurals. So this was very foreign to me. I thought it was quack type stuff. And Camille basically had to tell me, "I'm doing this."
I had to say, "You're getting on board. You are my husband. You are getting on board." What? He's pregnant? No, he's not pregnant. We're talking about him being a birth partner to me doing natural or unmedicated birth.
Well, and I guess I keep referring it to us. I really didn't do much. She's the one who gave birth. She's the one who did it. But I did feel like I was a lot more involved with this program. And that's one of the beneficial things that I found to it was... there's training for the birth partner. You get, or the husband, or whatever you want to call him. You get a packet. You get some audio tracks that I downloaded to my iPhone and just listened to at first begrudgingly. But later, I really enjoyed that I could be a part of my children's birth.
No, you have to tell them what really happened the first time you listened to a track.
I fell asleep?
No. Oh. So there is a track that the birth partner listens to that helps you kind of understand what the mother is going through as they're listening to the Hypnobabies tracks. And it takes you through the paths of relaxation to get you to levels of hypnosis. And a test that they do during the audio is that they say, now try to open your eyes, and if you are in hypnosis, you will not open your eyes. And he went through those steps and tried to open his eyes, and he couldn't open his eyes. And he freaked out, took the earphones out of his ears, and he's like, I'm not doing that again. That was freaky. That's what happened.
I've never been hypnotized either.
Yeah.
And I've been called up on stage. Like in high school, I was called up on stage by the hypnotist that comes. And I've never been hypnotized until I listened to that track. And it was kind of weird. But, you know, I really enjoyed when Camille was in labor. One of the things that they train the birth partner to do is when she's getting ready to push, you have to help her focus. And I got to be right in her face. I actually was grabbing her face. Mm-hmm. That's what she wanted me to do.
Right in the face.
And I would help her to focus on breathing and relaxation.
And the relaxation cues that help you to get back into that hypnotic zone.
Yeah.
So that you can create that hypnoanesthesia is what it's called. Now, hypnoanesthesia is a practice that people will use for surgery and dental work. So that if some people cannot take medication for whatever purpose, this is the same process that they go through to get their mind in a hypnotic state so that they are feeling that hypnoanesthesia so that you are not processing that pain and you are overcoming those thought processes of fear, and it takes you through that transition. So that's why your birth partner is so important for that part, because they can actually help you process those stages and stay focused, if that makes sense. Yeah, so going into that, that is why a birth partner is so essential in this process, because as you get to the later stages of labor and you're getting closer to transitioning and the head crowning and all of that glory, it is so important to have someone in your corner that understands that you need them to help you stay focused and in that zone that you've been practicing through the process of Hypnobabies. And this is a practice that you do individually, but it's also something that your partner practices with you in those last few weeks of preparation so that you're on the same page.
Well, and, you know, as a father, the birth of your child is already a very emotional thing to go through. I'm not a super emotional guy. Like, the last time I cried was when I watched Rudy in the theaters. It's been a while. But
trickling tear when we got married.
Yeah. But I felt like
13 years.
To me, it's already a very emotional time, and to be able to have control, a little bit of control, and to be able to help your wife through that process. And to me, it was just so much less stressful than when we had our first two children on a quasi semi epidural basis.
Yeah.
And it was just very fulfilling to me, and it's already an emotional time, but for me, it really augmented my emotions and made me feel like I was a partner. It made me feel like I was part of the process, even though I wasn't pregnant. I didn't push any babies out. I didn't feel any pain other than my hand getting squished a little bit. But it was nice to feel like I was part of the team and could help. And there were a couple other things I really liked about the program. I always tell Camille it was the two C's, cost and convenience. The program is like $175 or something like that.
That's for the total complete at-home study kit. So that's if you get this whole kit that comes with information for you covering the process of childbirth, health, wellness, how to get through the process of that pregnancy, positive affirmations, audio tracks for you and for the birth partner, and the whole thing. So that's everything that you can do at home, and that's the big part of convenience, especially for us.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and you can do it on your own time. You know, I think Camille mentioned some other programs last week, like hypnobirthing, Lamaze, where you have to go to a class.
Braxton Bradley
Bradley
method, yeah.
where you have to go to a class. Sometimes you have to bring someone into the room while you're giving birth, like a birth coach.
Which you can have a Hypnobabies doula if you want to bring someone in the room with you. I had my mother in with us as well, and I had her practice some of the tracks and be familiar with the key terms and relaxation cues as well. So really, I had two people on my team, and I felt really secure and supported in that. Where if you wanted to hire a Hypnobabies doula, a lot of women have incredible experiences doing that as well. So you can take classes in a hospital setting or in what's the word I'm looking for? Not a doctor, but a midwife. If you are going with a midwife, you can actually go to classes as well and have Hypnobabies training in person, but you can also study it at home. And that's what fit most for us. And I think that made you feel a lot more comfortable too.
Yeah, I really wasn't big on having an outsider in the room with us. Mm-hmm. I think there's already a lot of people in there, and it's such a personal time of your life. I really didn't want to have an outsider in there. So the fact that Camille could listen in her earbuds to her coaching and training, and also during labor, you know, she just had her earbuds in and was listening and focusing on calming herself and not feeling pain, I guess.
Or am it's I not just
that?
No.
I'm saying that totally wrong.
It's not just calming yourself. It's those cues that you've been practicing for self-hypnosis. So it's actually getting yourself to that deep level in your subconscious to kick on that hypnoanesthesia so you're not processing pain. So it's not just deep relaxation. It's actually doing that, bringing those keywords into that practice so that you're actually in that zone.
Well, and I think one thing that really made it successful for us, and that this is a prime example, is people who aren't familiar with the program are going to be skeptical. They're going to say weird things. Like, the program tells you that you should instruct everyone that it's a birthing wave and not a contraction. But I felt like we really didn't take that stuff seriously. I see Dave, Camille's dad.
My dad just tuned in.
We have different opinions
on this. Because in your own mindset, you do, the power of words is incredible. Because in media today, we hear everyone depict labor and childbirth as horrific and horrifying and scary and so painful. And yes, I have experienced that when I wasn't prepared with Hypnobabies, and it was awful. It was so painful. But the power of your mind is already conditioned to expect that horror, really. And so a big part of Hypnobabies training is studying of words and how you process your pregnancy and how you think and believe your birth will come to pass. It's a lot about the power of intention and the deepest subconscious understanding of delivery, if that makes any sense. And I will say, two of my good friends that are labor and delivery nurses were watching last week when I was doing live, and they also agreed that those who had committed to the process of Hypnobabies and practicing those deep levels of self-hypnosis, that it did work, and that is the process, that it's a commitment to the training, but it's exciting. It's such an exciting thing. By the time my delivery day comes around, I'm like doing squats, and I'm like, yeah, it's my delivery day. And I'm like this crazy person. You would think, what, who is she? It's so weird. And that's not how I used to be, but it was because I had practiced self-hypnosis and thinking about positive pregnancy and delivery and childbirth that I was able to make that transition with my mind, my intention, and my results. Almost to a crazy amount where you can put your mind in intention, where the first time I delivered with Hypnobabies, I said in my mind, I want to have this baby before 4 p.m. And I kid you not, that baby came at 3:45. And it was right before I had set in my mind. And not to say that things can't happen, because they do. Surprises will happen. You might have to go into an emergency C-section. You might have to do medication if something happens. And that's okay. these tools will actually help you to be able to be in a peaceful zone, zen, self-hypnosis place, so that if those things come up, it's not a horrific thing. It's something that you can process and you can get through because you've practiced and you've put these keys into place.
So, and I think that's a good point where, that was the point I was trying to make, is things are going to happen during labor. Mm-hmm. It's inevitable. But I felt like we took the stance where we weren't going to correct every nurse that called it a contraction.
Right. And because you have certain language that you practice within the program.
Yeah. And I have a hilarious video of your dad who's on where, I don't know if he even remembers this, where you're having a contraction. I'm taping you. Mm-hmm. We'll put this on YouTube for later viewing. Good thing from...
I missed it. Yep.
With the whole contraction.
Birthing wave, Dad. Birthing wave.
What?
It's called a birthing wave.
Oh, I'm sorry. A birthing wave. Birthing wave.
Because there is certain contraction that word is associated with pain. And so as you're practicing with Hypnobabies, you call it a birthing wave and you process it that way. So in my own mind, that's what I was calling it. But if a nurse came in and said, how are those contractions? I wasn't like, you can't call it that. You know,
you have to be ready for people to be skeptical.
Yeah.
Because there's, without a doubt, you know, we had a couple different nurses during each of your deliveries and
they were so skeptical. And who does this girl think she is? She is not doing this for real.
Yeah, and what would happen is, you know, you'd have one nurse who was skeptical, and then they would see how relaxed you were, and then by the end, they'd be like, oh yeah, she's doing great. And then the shift would change, a new one would come in, and it's like the skepticism comes all right back.
Yeah, yeah.
And so you've got to be able to roll with the punches. Camille had, in our last childbirth, they were trying to put an IV in her because they always want to put an IV in just in case something happens.
Yeah.
Some people, and I don't know if the program says this, but some people are totally against that. But we felt like, you know, we're in a hospital.
Well, that's actually a requirement. Oh, so if you're delivering in a hospital, they will ask that you put a saline lock in your hand so that there's access to a vein. So that if there was an emergency and you wanted to have medication, or if you wanted to have a C-section, or not wanted, or needed, whatever it is, that they have access to that and they have the ability to get to that quickly if there is a situation where they need to step in and do something else. So you'll see in the videos, I do have an IV in me, but it's not attached to anything. So it's called a saline lock is what it's called. And some hospitals require that. I think if you deliver it like a midwife center or different birthing centers like that, they may not require it. But the hospitals where we were, that was required. And I was okay with that. That actually gave us like a sense of security a little bit, so that if there was a situation where I needed to go into surgery, or if something happened where I needed medication right away, if there was distress with the baby or something needed to happen, I was in a situation where I could do that. So there was a few comments. I'm going to scroll back just a quick minute and see what.
Well, and I'll point out that, you know, in our last baby, Camille had an intern giving her IV.
That was seriously the most painful part of my delivery, was three different women trying to give me an IV. And I was getting so upset because it was delaying my labor progression and mm-hmm. my ability to progress my labor. And honestly, I was like, this dang IV, because I didn't even need it.
And you're trying to be relaxed.
Yeah, I'm trying to be relaxed. And so there are things about being in a hospital where it's not always going to be perfect and ideal. And that's why some people want to deliver at home, and that's okay. And if that's what makes you feel most comfortable and secure, then that's great too. I've had a lot of friends who have had experiences that way, and it's been wonderful. So Amber says,
don't sweat the small stuff.
Don't sweat the small stuff, yeah. Amber says, so can the file be downloaded onto a computer, then sent to a smartphone? Do you listen to the tracks during labor or just leading up to? Yeah, Amber, good question. So when you purchase your pack with the at-home study course, you can purchase the audio tracks individually, like from iTunes, or when you get the pack, it comes in CDs, and then you download it to your computer, and then you transfer it to your phone. That's what I did.
And then it might be.
But you can just purchase the audio tracks.
And I think it might be on a thumb drive now. I think
it's changed a little bit.
We bought it, what, 5 years ago?
Yeah. How many years? Probably four years. 4 years ago. So yeah, those audio files, I keep them on my phone. I use them for the practicing all the weeks leading up to my birthing. So it's a 6 week program, but the last week is maintenance. The first week is more an introduction to the program. So there's 3 to 4 solid weeks where you're practicing Hypnobabies, listening to the tracks 20 to 40 minutes every day. And that it's more about you finding a space and time at the end of the day where it's your practice. You get to lay down and it's just very soothing and you get to rest. And it's your special time to enjoy those audio tracks. So when you are in labor, there are tracks that change. So you do it in a progression actually, where you get better at getting yourself into self-hypnosis. And as you get better at doing that, then you go into deepening and creating hypnoanesthesia is what it's called. So that's what's applied as for people who use that pain maintenance for whether they're in childbirth, getting dental work done, or they're in surgery. So this is actually the same process of doing that, where you can practice to get in that self-hypnosis into that very deepest level. And then as you are leading up into delivery, there's actually tracks you're not supposed to listen to, because there's tracks that are called baby come out when you're like towards the end, and or if you go over term and you want to progress the baby coming out, you actually will listen to these tracks to help that happen. And then there's specific tracks for when you're in the early stages of labor and pushing the baby out. So yes, there is totally a process there of how you progress in practicing and getting better as you go. And then the actual tracks, the audio tracks that you'll have in your phone for when you are in labor.
And this is the best part about Hypnobabies. Because
what is the best part?
For the birthing partner, all I did was sat there during the whole time she was in labor. And you can watch
some. But that's not how it is for everyone.
Right. So last week she showed, and we've shared on her YouTube channel, video of her actually in labor. And literally me and her mom were just sitting there. Like,
they got pretty bored.
It was like she was asleep. It was crazy. And at times when she was dilated to an 8, I mean, it wasn't, we really didn't have to spring into action until you started pushing. And so,
honestly, that was the most incredible moment, because as you're preparing for this, the whole time you're thinking, is this going to work for me? Is this real? Am I doing this right? Because, you know, everyone processes it a little differently, and your pain threshold and the way that you practice and if you were consistent and all of these tools come into play. So the very first time I was doing this, I didn't know. I was practicing. I was doing all the things that I had been preparing for all along. I was super diligent about it. And as we were going through it, I was like, okay, this seems really similar to what I've done before, but it was so different. I was able to be in that self-hypnotic place. And literally, if you saw me, you would have thought I was sleeping. So when a doctor came in, or a nurse came in rather, to check me, they checked me, and they suggest when you're going through Hypnobabies to not get checked often, because it can interrupt your zen, basically, or being in that self-hypnosis. So they suggest not to do it very often, but of course that's up to you again, and those decisions are yours. But they checked me, and I was at an 8. And when they told me, you are at an 8, and I had just been laying and doing this practice that I had been doing, I started to cry. And I was like, oh my gosh, this is actually working. And I will be honest, it did make me lose my train of thought a little bit, because it was so overwhelming in a positive way that I was like, oh my gosh. And it wasn't until I flipped back over, I'd been resting and listening to the tracks on my side, because that's how I practice, and I try to replicate that as well as I can when I am actually in labor, so that I can go to that same place. I flipped over and I went from an 8 to a 10 in a matter of 10 minutes. So it progressed very quickly, and it was during that transition time that you really need your partner with you, because the body and what the contractions are doing changes from dilation to the baby coming out. And I did feel pain at that moment with the head crowning. I'm not going to lie. Like, I felt that. Some women say that they don't feel that, and I believe them. If that's how it was for them, that's fine. But for me, I did feel the ring of fire, and it was intense. But because of the tools of Hypnobabies, I was able to do it, and I was able to get through that, and in big part due to my husband, because he was a great partner, and to my mom that was with me by my side.
Well, one other thing to keep in mind as a husband or birth partner is after she has the child, you know, your role increases a lot, where with our first two, I was helping you out of bed a lot. And I would just say the difference in your recovery was unbelievable between when you were, you know, had all sorts of Pitocin and fluids in you and an epidural that maybe kicked in late. Mm-hmm. You know, you were up and walking right after birth. It was
really, I wouldn't say right after, because I get major shakes after having a baby. My body feels really like a little bit out of control.
But I remember having to pump the brakes with you
not
a little
right
bit
after.
And saying, you know, you need to sit down for them and settle down.
But I just felt
just
so good.
Had a baby.
I was like, I feel good. Where after the others, it was not.
But long story short, yes, was it Amber? So
yeah.
We did. We got them in CDs, but we burned them onto our computer and put them on our phones. There is a track for the birthing partner.
There's more than one.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
I don't know how many I listened to, but I remember listening to them at night, and they would just put me right to sleep.
Yeah, he was snoring in no time, which is actually really cool when you're listening to the audio tracks. If you do fall asleep, it's okay, because your brain is still processing the information on a subconscious level.
Uh-oh.
Which
you're
I think is really cool.
Now. You're getting quacky.
It's true. It is true.
You think
there
you
is
were
actually
hypnotized while you were sleeping?
Oh, yeah. Right. Yeah, because your body, it's funny because they'll do a process where you're in that place and you don't really remember falling asleep. But then at the end, she'll go 3, 2, 1, and you'll wake up. And I'll be like, oh, it's over.
See, I'm still
story.
A skeptic.
True
even
story.
Though you've been
I know.
Through it twice.
It's
I
true.
Should know by now.
So Angel says, wish they had this 40 years ago when I gave birth without any pain management. Was happy I had short labors. Oh, I know. And that's why I feel like even now that it's available, it's still really new. And that's why I am doing this. Because I am so passionate about it. And I want people to know. Because had I not gone through that process of having had bad experiences with my epidurals, I don't think I ever would have entertained the idea of having a natural labor or an unmedicated labor. And I just feel like it's a unique experience to share. So that's, thank you for saying that, because I feel the same way. And Amber says, thank you. Wish I knew about this sooner. I'm due June 11th. Oh yeah, that's soon. So I don't know if this is your first baby, Amber, but I do think there is a benefit a little bit to having had a baby in whichever way that you chose to have a baby and see how that process was for you. And if going the unmedicated route might be a good option for you. If you haven't had a baby before, I think that the first labor is generally a lot longer. And because I had had an epidural that first time around, I don't know how well I would have done with Hypnobabies the first time. I don't know. But if you have had a baby and you've had that experience, at least going forward, you can think about this maybe for the future. So I'm sorry that you didn't hear about it sooner, but you could, there are a few audio tracks that you could download and listen to about having positive affirmations about your birth and just being really happy and excited about it. And Amber, that's something that you could listen to right now. And even apply that even while you're in those first stages and you're dilating to a 1, 2, 3, 4 before you are medicated or however it is you decide to do that. And it's super powerful. So even though you don't have the ability to go through the whole thing that way, you could definitely apply the tools and it would be super powerful. Make sure that you use the code MyMommyStyle and it will give you 10% off any of those tracks. There are also tracks that help with helping a baby sleep at night, helping you sleep at night if you deal with postpartum or anxiety, and also tracks with relaxation in general or creating intention. So there's a lot of options. So I would just look at it and see, because even the positive pregnancy and labor affirmations helped me a lot to just go into that day of delivery and feel awesome, like really feel excited about it. Hi, Kristen. I don't know if you're still with us. So what were you?
That's all I've got.